Namaskar and welcome back to eLearners Hub. You are watching Cloud Computing Tutorials, and in this video we'll see how to install Citrix Xen Server. So in the last video we saw how to create a virtual machine for Citrix Xen Server. In this video we'll see how to install Citrix Xen Server in the virtual machine. So here we are in the VMware workstation. So in the last video we created this virtual machine, and now you will see the installation process of Citrix Xen Server. So we have assigned the ISO file here, and now let's power on this virtual machine. So once you click in this virtual machine window, you'll see that your mouse is unusable, that is you are not able to use your mouse, and here you will have to use your keyboard. So the installation has started. So you have to select the keyboard, the US keyboard, press the tab key, OK. Press the enter key to fire the commands. OK. Accept the user license agreement. So we are going to use the virtual machine storage as 60 GB, that is what we created while creating the virtual machine, and click on OK. Local media, OK. Would you like to install any supplement packs? We say no. Verification installation source. So you can skip the verification. Here you need to provide the password. This is the password of your root login. And here we will select the DHCP mode. We will not assign the IP address, so we will select the DHCP mode. Click OK. Host configuration. So now this is where you can provide the name of your server. So let's change it to Xen Server, and DNS configuration via DHCP. So we are using the DHCP mode of configuration. OK. Now here you need to select the geographical area, so we fall in the Asia, so we'll use the Asia here. Now you need to select the city or the area, so let's look for Calcutta and click OK. Using NTP, okay. So again, NTP is configured by DHCP server. So again, we don't have to provide here any IP address or the NTP server URLs. Click OK and install Xen Server. So installation will take a while. Have patience and relax. Now it will reboot the system and click OK. this is the initial screen of Citrix Zen server. You can see we don't have any GUI, just a screen that shows you the system configuration. You can see the status it displays on the right side. You can see the IP address of the system, network and management interfaces. So when you enter this, you will see various menus here. If you want to configure the interface, enter. So whenever you want to change anything, you will have to log in into this and provide a username and password, and can change the settings. So this is the network interface card. So right now we are not going to make any changes. I'll press escape, and this is the main screen where you can see various options. So for making the network settings, the authentication, virtual machine. So if there are any virtual machines on this Citrix Zen server, you can see the virtual machines. It shows you the storage, if there are any storage repositories, resource pool configuration, hardware and BIOS information. If you want to change the keyboard and time zones, you can simply press the enter key and select the time zone and keyboard layout. Remote service configuration, backup, restore and update. So you can take the backup and restore. Technical support, you can reboot or shut down. And you can also enter the local command shell. So it will provide you the shell for entering the commands for your Zen server. So this is what is the interface that is provided by Citrix Zen server. So in this video we saw the installation, and we just has had a look at all the menus and the options that are available on the main screen of Citrix Zen. In the next video we will see installing the Zen client on the host machine, that is our Windows 10 machine, and we will access this server from the Zen client machine, and we'll see how we can create a virtual machine there. So before doing that, we have to install a Windows 7, that is we have to create a Windows 7 virtual machine that will work as the storage repository to us. So if you like the video, please click on the like button and share your views and suggestions in the comments below. Encourage us by clicking on the subscribe button, and also do not forget to share on the alert bell so that you don't miss our upcoming videos on our channel. See you in the next video. Till then, take care. Thank you.